Hello everyone and welcome to the Trachtbach site visit. We are in Brienz, a small village in Switzerland. So as you can see, down there is the Trachtbach, a small river, and it originates in the catchment above Brienz out of three smaller streams. So what happened and why are we here? In August 2006, over 3 days, a heavy rainfall occurred. And with that, a slide happened in the catchment. It was about the size of 60,000 cubic meters. Out of that 60,000 cubic meter, half of it ended up as a debris flow. So it damaged houses underneath here in Brienz. After this event, safety concept was worked out and protection measures were initiated. And actually these protection measures we are going to check out right now. So to protect the village, there is either the possibility to displace the flow around the village or to retain the material above the village and let smaller volume pass through that channelized channel into the lake. So that channelized channel is important because due to that riverbed, we do not have high friction, and that's why we have higher velocity and the smaller volumes are getting down fast into the lake. And the other thing is we need a structure to retain the material, and therefore they've chosen flexible debris flow barriers. So to retain a certain amount of volume, they need more than one flexible debris flow barrier. In that case, there are three barriers in a row installed. We just passed barrier number one underneath and barrier number two. And as you can see up here is barrier number three. We are in front of a VX140H4. So the concept of multi-level system is that we have more than one barrier in a row. So in case the debris flow is coming, it is passing the first barrier, maybe the second one, and hitting it and hits the third one. So that's why we need that basalt opening. That is the opening between the bottom support ropes and the riverbed. So as I mentioned before, the goal was to let pass smaller volumes. So smaller volumes are passing here, the first barrier, the second one, and even the third one, and is going directly with the channel into the lake. In case of larger volumes, the barrier gets hit and gets filled up. And in case of there is a huge volume, all the barriers are filled, they are still able to overtop. As I mentioned, Trachtbach originates out of three streams. Two of them are joining right now here. So one on the left side and one on the right side. The failure happened up there. So the slide happened there and lots of material, basically half of it, got deposited down there. And the other half ended up in the village as debris flow. So to prevent and also to retain some of the material, they constructed that concrete measure behind me. To retain material from the other stream on the left side, there is also another flexible debris flow barrier, what we're just going to check out right now. So we are next to the UX160H4. As you can see, there are posts in the systems and retaining ropes with brake elements in there. That is in comparison to the VX system we just saw below. Both systems have abrasion protection on top of the support ropes. They are needed in case of overflow that the support ropes are covered. As I mentioned, the system has posts, as you can see there. So the post is sitting on a 1 by 1 by 1 meter foundation. In case of erosion due to the water, you have to prevent the foundation. You can do that with large boulders or with a riprap, and also or with concrete, and also try to stabilize the riverbed that there is no erosion occurring. So to dimension such barriers, we have a pre-dimensioning tool, it's called depth flow. And there is also the possibility of numerical simulation. So just to sum up, like our today Trachtbach site visit, we saw that three multi-level system VX140H4 underneath there. And we saw that large one, VX160H4 up here. And all that measures also with the concrete construction are preventing the village Brienz from further debris flow. So I hope you enjoyed the virtual site visit and you had fun. And I hope you also have fun with the further program from GeoSummit. Bye bye.